Why, good morning, saints. How are you doing today? I am so honored today. Look who's in the house with Brother Steve. You know, I've been trying to get people to come down and do a little interview with me, and look who I've got. They've come down here, and doesn't Brother Andy look so good? And why he looks so good is because he's sitting next to Miss Becky. That's why he looks so good. But that uniform looks good too, doesn't it? Here it is, Memorial Day weekend. Tomorrow will be Memorial Day. Today we're having our Memorial Day service in the services. We're going to have some fried chicken. We're going to have some green beans. Amen. We're going to have some mashed potatoes, some salad, and whatever desserts you ladies bring in just a couple hours. We're looking forward to a great time in God's house today. Boy, I was at choir practice yesterday, and did they ever do such a good job. Amen. I want to tell you something. Your cup will be full this morning, later on today, whenever you come into the house of God and hear the saints of God singing. Well, this morning, I'd like to just talk with Brother Andy and Miss Becky and just see how they're doing, okay? And if you'd like to be with me one Sunday morning, why don't you give me a call and we can work up something where we could come and talk, okay? Well, let me ask you, Brother Andy, how are you doing right now?
Doing good. I'm doing great.
Are you?
Yeah. How are you serving the COVID-19? Well, we're doing good. We cheat a little bit, go out and ride around and go to store stuff. But
oh, so you didn't stay home the whole time?
No.
You went out and partied around, huh?
I don't know about partying, but we got out.
You got out, huh?
We even got to play dominoes a couple nights with friends.
Did you really?
Yeah.
That is great. No. You know, what do you think about this COVID situation?
I think it's all phony. Put on deal to suppress us, to be under government thumb, to do what they want instead of having a free constitution as it should be.
Yeah, you know, you swore allegiance to that constitution put on that uniform.
Yeah.
It means everything, doesn't it?
Amen.
Yeah. Miss Becky, what do you think about the COVID situation?
My thoughts, I don't know how true it is, but I really believe that it's a farce. I believe it's an action to put us under government control and to scare us. And if people are scared, they're going to obey.
And how true that is.
Right.
Yeah. Well, let me ask you this. You know, you guys, because of the COVID, I know that we have seen you around here a lot longer than what we normally do. Right. And that's a good thing. Praise the Lord for that. Yeah. But I guess fairs are being canceled. Is that correct?
Yes, it is.
Yes.
The future fair coming up, the first one would be in Michigan if they open it up. There's four fairs we do up there. And if they open it up, we'll do all four of them this winter, summer. And then we'll come back home. But I just pray that it get opened up. I'm getting antsy. I want to see souls saved.
Amen. Amen. Now, you're not getting any cabin fever, are you?
No.
No? Okay, good. Because I heard a preacher preach about cabin fever for just a little
bit
there.
Yeah, I did too. Yeah.
You did too, huh? Okay, well, good.
You're a good friend of mine.
A real good friend of yours, huh? Okay. Well, so let me see. What are y'all's future plans? What do you plan on doing? Are y'all going to go anywhere, or?
We're going to go up at least to visit and do the fairs if they open up.
Okay, great. That'll be great. I know one thing. Your family would be so honored and so glad to see y'all for just a little bit, and that'll be good. You might even find some cool air, but I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't know.
I heard that it could be hot even in Michigan. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But it won't be quite as humid here. You know, the air's so thick.
Right.
But let me ask you one more thing. This is Memorial Day. Okay. Mm. This is a day that's different than Veterans Day. Veterans Day, we honor all the veterans, all those who serve. This is Memorial Day. This is the honoring those who specifically died.
Right.
in fighting for our freedoms.
Right.
What do you think about this, Brother Andy, as far as a military man, and what do you think about
Well, I've seen a lot of people. I've hauled a lot of people when I was over in Vietnam out of there, and everyone was a problem for me. But, you know, they served our country, so that we have freedom over here. And I don't take that lightly, and neither should anyone else, because of what we got. I've been around most of the world, and in all the years I was in service, and I've seen that this is the best one. And we need to stick by and stand up and be counted for, for the ones that died for us.
Amen. Well said. Very well said. God bless your heart. Well, on that note, let's have a word of prayer. Amen. And we'll tell the saints that we'll see them just a few moments in the house of God. Now, some of them are still in their pajamas when they watch this. We'll see. Look at us. We're already up early and we're ready for church to start. But we'll see y'all in just a little bit. God bless you. Have a great day. And saints, you go serve your King. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we love you and thank you for your blessings. And Father, on this very special day, when we think about the freedoms we have as Americans, Lord, we pray that you would help us to be thankful. And Father, help us to live lives that are worthy of such sacrifices by so many. Father, thank you for those who have served. And Father, even in this COVID time, Father, we think of the frontline responders, Lord. We pray that you bless them as well. And Lord, we just pray that today you give us a special day in your house. Father, thank you for those who fasted and prayed on Saturday. And Lord, I pray today, Lord, that there would be a great moving of your precious Holy Spirit. Father, help us to respond in the right way, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you now.
Amen.